So good afternoon to all of you students. Today we are going to understand about the propositions. Proposition is basically whenever we study the discrete mathematics, we start from the propositions. So this is very important part of mathematical logic, or we can say the reasoning. So let us see. So if we talk about the propositions, then because this is the part of mathematical reasoning, or we can say the logical reasoning, so the journey of this proposition is started from we can say 22 or 2300 years back, when we talk about the great scientist or philosopher Aristotle. So we can say the Greek scientist philosopher Aristotle is said to be the first person, he is said to be the first person who have studied this logical reasoning. Then we say the mathematical logic, this is the base of this mathematical logic, or we can say mathematical reasoning. This is the base of several areas if you want to study the other areas, like if you want to study computer science, artificial intelligence, discrete mathematics, digital electronics, then we need to know the mathematical logic. If we are knowing the mathematical logic, it is easy to understand these subjects like computer science, artificial intelligence, and various algorithms can be understood easily. So we can say this is the base. This is the base of several areas. Now, the one component of logic is, as we are saying, that this is very important component, that is proposition. So important one component of logic is, this is proposition, and it deals with the statements. It deals with those statements, or we can say those sentences which have the either true value or false value. So the component of logic is proposition, which deals with the statements with true or false values. Now it can be defined. So in simple way we can define it, this proposition can be defined. It is a declarative sentence. It is a declarative sentence that has the value either true or false. So we can say proposition or a statement, this proposition is also, we can also say this is a statement. Proposition or a statement is a declarative sentence that is either true or false. So this is the formal definition of the proposition. Now we will see some examples. Like this is the first example. Now let us see whether it is proposition or not. So first example says 2 plus 3 equals 5. 2 plus 3 equals 5, this is true. So this is true, its value is true. So we can say, as we are saying the proposition, this is a declarative sentence and it should have the value either true or false. And the value of this sentence is true. So we will say this is a proposition. Now let us take the second example, 5 minus 2 equals 3. Again this is true, because if we subtract 2 from 5, this equals 3. So again this is true. So this is also a proposition. Now the third example, 3 is less than 0. 3 is not less than 0. This is false. So this is false, we can say this is false. So because its value is false, so again this is a proposition. These are having value true, true. So 3 is less than 0, this is, its value is false. So again it is a proposition. Now in the fifth example, x plus y is greater than 7. It is unclear here whether this x plus y is greater than 7 or not. because it will depend on the value of x and y. But here we are not knowing the value of x and y because these are the two variables. So here it is unclear. So we can say this is not a proposition. This is not a proposition. Now, moreover, the truth and falsity of a proposition, this is called its truth value. Truth and falsity of a proposition, this is called its truth value, and it can also be shown by using some truth tables for various connectives that we will see later, like conjunction, disjunction, conditional, biconditional, negation, etc. Those all can be explained using the truth tables, and these truth tables are nothing but they have the values either true and false. So we can say truth and falsity of a proposition, this is called its truth value. This proposition is also called two-valued logic. It is clear because it is having two values, either true or false. That's why it is also called two-valued logic, as only two values are permitted. Now, it is to be noted here, commands, all the commands in which we are saying like open the door, close the door, open the window, etc. So they are not the propositions. Commands are not the propositions. On the other hand, questions, all the questions, if the sentence is a question, that is also not a proposition. Like, what is your name? Who are you? Where are you going? Have you taken your breakfast? Where do you go? From where you are coming? And so on. So, second one is questions. Questions are not the proposition. And third one is exclamations. Or the exclamations are also not the part of proposition. They are not the propositions. Like we can say, what a sunny day. What a cold day, what a cold evening, hurrah, we have won the match, like this. So all the exclamations are not propositions. So it is to be noted here that commands, questions, exclamations are not propositions. Now we'll see some more examples. Like first example is, sun rises in the east. So this is true, this is true, we know this is true, so this is a proposition. Second example is 3 plus 4 equals to 7, this is also true, so we can say this is also a proposition. And the third example, 2 comma 3, this pair, this is a proper subset of 2, 3, 7, again this is true, so we can say this is also a proposition. Now we come to the fourth example. And the fourth example is, four sentences, have you taken your breakfast? So this is a question. This sentence is a question, so it can't be a proposition. Because we have written here, commands, questions, exclamations are not proposition. So this will not be a proposition. Next example is 7 minus x equals to 5. Again here it is unclear because whether this 7 minus x is equals to 5 or not, it will depend on the value of x. It will depend on the value of x. So we can say this is also not the proposition. Because 7 minus x, the value of 7 minus x will depend on the value of x, and x is a variable. Next is, open the window. This is a command. If we are saying like open the window, open the door, close the door, like this, they all are the commands. So this is also not the proposition. This is not the proposition. Then, eighth example is, what a cold evening. This is exclamation, what a cold evening. It will have a sign of exclamation The sentence like what a cold evening, what a sunny day, what a beautiful morning, hurrah, we have won the match. These type of sentences include sign of exclamation. So this is also not the proposition. Not a proposition. Furthermore, the propositions can be represented using variables like P, Q and R. Let us say we can consider any example like we are saying sun rises in the east. So it can be represented by using the variable P. We can use the variable P, but it is to be noted here that if we are using a particular variable, then it is not necessary a proposition variable is not a proposition. It is not necessary that if we are saying that P is a proposition variable, then it will be a proposition. So proposition variable is not a proposition, but it can be represented by it. Furthermore, T and F, these two letters like capital T and capital F, they are also known as the propositional constants. They are the propositional constants. So if we are saying that a particular sentence is a proposition, then we can say, and it is represented using a variable, then we can say P is T, P is F, and so on. Here we can see, so if T and F are two propositional constants, hence the proposition, let us consider any proposition, like this is any proposition, the sun rises in the east, it can be represented as P is T, like this. And we are saying this is P. This proposition is P. So the proposition, the sun rises in the east, it can be represented by P is T because this proposition is true. So this is all about the propositions. Now we will elaborate this topic and we will see the connectives. In those connectives, we will see like conditional statement, biconditional, conjunction, disjunction and negation. So let us see in the next video.